Okay, chaps and chapesses, let's continue now with our playing. So far we've mastered now five notes. We've got the old consonants, the A and the E there. We've got the blues note at C. We've got the blues note at G. And we've got the gateway pathway note there, which is a D on the third string. Now, I call it a pathway or passageway note for a reason. Because if we come down to the fifth fret on the third string, we've got this note. And guess what? That's the same note. It's a blues note. It's the same note as the C that we play on the first string, eighth fret, but an octave lower. So we're starting our journey of the pentatonic scale again, but an octave lower. So we've gone to the pathway. Now we start again with a C blues note. So the next note logically we know is going to be our root, our consonant root, which is there on the fourth string, seventh fret. So we've gone down through the notes we all know already. That's the pathway gateway note. To our C blues note, down to our consonant. Now, below the consonant we know we've got another blues note, which in this case is on the 4th string at the 5th fret. And we're starting to build some patterns up now. Do you remember originally we had the, on the first two strings, what I sort of jokingly call the dancing girl's legs. I quite, you know, reasonably long 3-fret stretches. And then we're coming down to the third string, the pathway note, down to the blues note. Here's a smaller span. It's a 2-note span. Then down to the root note on the 4th string, down to the blues note below it, the 7th, there's a 2-note span again. So we've got, on the 3rd and 4th strings, we've got a couple of 2-note spans, which give a totally different sort of sound quality. So if we're taking, those big spans have quite a different sound quality. Now continuing down, we're still, so we're on the 4th string, 7th fret down to 5th fret. Now down to the 5th string, 7th fret. And that's our E note again. Remember we originally played it on the 2nd string up here? Our other consonant notes. So, and then we come down to another passageway notes on the, still on the 5th string, 5th fret. That's our good old passageway note again. So we know we're now about to come down to start our pentatonic scale all over again on the 6th string, this time on the 8th fret. And then finally down to one more root consonant note on the 5th fret. So all the way down it's, and you can start to see some interesting patterns there, can't you? You've got the leg patterns on the top two strings, and then on the next three strings it's like what I think of as a little sort of little flat roofed house, the sort of thing you might see down in the Delta somewhere, I guess. Really primitive sort of flat roofed house, like a little shack really with a flat roof. Trying to keep that blues analogy going. And lastly, we've got the one leg again. That's a one-legged blues dancer. So the two legs into our little flat-roofed house, down to the one-legged dancer at the end. Okay, now I've got one more note to show you quickly, and it's probably the most important note of the lot. And it's the key to the real blues. It's called the flattened fifth note. And it sits on the halfway. Now, if we go up to the second string, we've got the E there on the fifth string, and then we've got our pathway note, D on the third string, seventh fret. Now, between the two, there's a note, and that's the flattened fifth. And it's probably the bluesiest note of the lot, the most discordant of the lot. It is a note of nature, but it's really discordant, so... And I've left it out so far, but it's probably the note that's going to most define the blues, particularly in jazz music, where it's used extensively. That's much later on in this programme. So think of it as one note up from the pathway note. And again, if we move down to the fifth string, we've got a pathway note on the fifth fret there on the fifth string. One up from that, and we find the blue note again, the flattened fifth. So can you feel that tonality? So I want you now, you've got the whole set now, and you can see this is a really guitar, it's the most guitaristic shape of the lot, this. And it's used continually, you hear it time and time again in rock and roll, blues, in forms of jazz, in folk music. And if you can, once you've mastered this, I tell you, you'll be able to play any blues or rock and roll tune, and I'm going to teach you some really cool stuff to put some of these notes together. But right even now, you know, really almost now, as much as there is to know about the blues. And the key to it, when we get into tone centers, is just taking that guitaristic shape of the dancing legs, the shack, the one leg at the end, taking that anywhere up the fretboard. So just quickly, we're in A now. If you wanted to play in C, you just go up three frets up to here and just play the same damn thing. And you're in the key of C. Again, back to A now. If you wanted to play in G, just take it down two frets to G and just do the same damn thing again. Playing in the key of G, but I'm going to stop there because there are more notes to come yet, and I want you to take that in and get competent with